out for a glimpse of your profile. I'd recognize you even after a while. You felt like you were flying when the train crossed the river. It was your favorite part of the ride. I pretended I am flying, soaring with you.
Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm Violet, and today I am taking Coyote and Clover Boy to the Baranis' racetrack, and we're gonna do a little bit of a training show for the Pony Championships. So they've basically just arranged, I cannot explain it any easier, just a training show. Basically how it works is that you just go do the warm-up, do your round as if you were on the competition, but it's actually just training, so your results aren't counting anywhere and you don't get a rosette. So yeah, we're just gonna do it for a little bit of a fun time. I'm just gonna see how they behave in that environment, especially with Clover. I know that Coyote is a superstar, but Clover, I haven't taken him out to a show since his first one, and that was like little 30 centimeter jumps. Now he's doing meter 40, so that's a little bit of a jump up. That's meter 10 higher, so we're just gonna see how they go. I'm not gonna pop any pressure on them. It's just to see what we still need to work on, because the Pony Championships are gonna be like early to mid-June, and that's gonna be basically out next week when the entries open. So we're just gonna enter them both. And I already said that in a video, but Domino, as I said, is not going with us this year. He's just a happy hacker currently. He does jump still. We do it once a week or once every few weeks, because he really does enjoy it, but I don't want to put any extra pressure on him that I don't need to. So I'm gonna stop blabbing on now, and I'm gonna pop these guys into the trailer. Okay, so first of all, I popped in Coyote, just because he's a little bit calmer than Clover, and then obviously we also popped Clover in, and today he was actually pretty chill. I was a little bit impressed or surprised by that, but the drive wasn't long. It was about 2 hours, and there wasn't any traffic, so I was happy with that. We were a little bit early, actually, which is, so I popped both of them out, and we put both of them out, because I didn't want either of them to just stand in the trailer, so we just tied them up to separate parts of the trailer or sides, so that, you know, they wouldn't have any mischievous ideas. And then I got myself changed, and it was time to tack up Coyote. I decided I'm just gonna go with Coyote first, and I was with him first on the chart, so that worked out fine. We popped on his boots and lastly his jumping bridle, and it was time to get warming up. So in the warm-up, he was actually really good. He did have a bit of extra energy that I wanted to kind of preserve, but still burn out a little bit, so we didn't have any mishaps. But other than that, I think our striding today was, it was good. We really clicked. So he's been working fine. Then we just decided we're gonna pop some bigger jumps, which we also went for a good stride. I don't know, I think my riding today was pretty good. And after the warm-up, we went into the main arena, where we popped over a few jumps.
Thought the praying would make it better, but I swear to God, I'm just as lost as ever. Thought the bottle would hold me over,
still hurt me just as bad when I got sober. Everyone around me's found a way to let it go, but I can't help but focus on the things I can't control. All the darkness in my mind, pain that I can't leave behind. I know there's a silver line that I can't see. All the cold and sleepless nights, running out of ways to fight. I know there's a morning light in my reach. If I keep buying time, I stopped going out to bars, I quit smoking. Thought that giving that all up would keep me going. I got over people pleasing. I quit falling into love that had no meaning. I could search forever for a peace I'll never know, but I can't help but focus on the things I can't control. All the darkness in my mind, pain that I can't leave behind.
So yeah, then we came back and I untucked him, and then my beautiful groom took him out for a little bit of a walk around just to get that sweat out. And I went in to tag Clover up because he was next and obviously last. I'm taking just two horses on this one. But yeah, he was good tucking up. He stood very still, which I was also surprised about. He was definitely full of surprises today. And again, we went into the warm-up with him. He didn't throw any fuss. He was really calm. And he hasn't been here yet, at least if I remember correctly. So yeah, he was really calm. We went to the warm-up, obviously started with a little the lower jumps. The only thing I was a little bit worried with him was the water tray, because he hasn't jumped water yet. He was close to water and he's been in water, but he hasn't jumped over water yet. So I just I was a little bit skeptical about that, but we're gonna come back to that later. But no, he was good in warm up. As I said, he was fine, very calm. He jumped them with so much confidence. So just did that final one, which was a little bit bigger, and then again, it was time to go and do a round.
Oh, there's a silver line that I can't see. All the cold and sleepless nights, running out of ways to fight. I know there's a morning light in my reach. If I keep buying time, there's a storm inside my dreams. I'm still standing on two feet. Let the current carry me when the in my mind, pain that I can't leave behind. I know there's a silver line that I can't see. All the cold and sleepless nights, running out of ways to fight. I know there's a morning light in my reach. If I keep buying time.
He did get that refusal at the water, but he did jump it confidently the second time, which is what I was aiming for, so I was still happy at the end. But then we untucked him, we gave him a little bit of a walk around for him to just kind of stop sweating a little bit. So then it was another 2-hour drive home, but we did get home before the sunset, so that was nice. I still had some time to have a quick lunch with Angel, and the pregnancy video is gonna be up when she has her foal, so that's just gonna be a hole-in-one video. Probably it's gonna be a little bit of a longer one, but yeah, I'm just gonna work with that. But we popped both of the boys back inside, and then they had their dinner. So I just thought I'd end this vlog with Domino right here. But yeah, the Veronica's Championship, the Pony Championships, are 100% going to be held at the Veronica's racetrack this year. But the Yorvik 10 may very possibly be held at Yorvik Stables this year, which I am excited for a little bit of a scenery change. It hasn't been confirmed yet since it's in a few months. It's now 4 months, I believe, to be exact. But yeah, we still have some time to figure that out. I'm gonna go either way, so yeah, I'm gonna finish this vlog here. If you liked it, make sure to like and subscribe, because it really does help me out and I really do appreciate it. I love to chat up with you guys on my Instagram, which is at violet_brewwords, but I also reply to every single one of your comments if you decide to do so and comment down below. If you don't wanna miss the Pony Championship video, which is gonna be up soon, obviously, when we come to that, make sure to hit that notification bell so you don't miss it. But yeah, hopefully you have a really, really nice morning, day or night, and I'll hopefully see you in the next one. Bye!